Hi there, Natalie with you today with a new process video. And today I want to show you how easy it is to incorporate metal dies when creating your next scrapbook layout. So much you can do with them, and I'm going to show you a few tricks on how you can bring a lot of color into your next scrapbook layout. So join me. For today's projects, we're going to focus on using two of the newest dies, the Soda Top Nesting Dies. That's going to be the one that's going to create the background. I'm going to use a little bit of the ink blending tool just to bring some color to the background. That's pretty much all the color that we're going to add. And then the rest is going to be based on die cutting. And I'm also going to use the Beady Bloom die set, and an old set, probably one of my favorite, is the Layer Floor Elements. So let me just get started. So I'm starting by cutting, this is heavy cardstock, white heavy cardstock. I'm gonna cut around a 4.5 inch wide, 4.5 by 12 inch strip of the white cardstock, and I'm gonna use the Soda Top Nesting Dies to create the little impression on the background. Think of it as creating my own cut file. I just wanna have these empty spaces on the white cardstock or on the white paper strip where I can add color and a little itty bit of blooms. Think of it as little windows. So all I'm doing right now is just playing with the dies just to position them. I want some of them to be right at the edge. I want some of them to be in the middle. And in a way, you're gonna see that I create kind of an S shape, a zigzag on my page. So I took it off camera to my big die cutting machine and I just cut it everything. I was careful. You're gonna see that there's some areas where I have very little delicate cuts, but I'm just gonna be careful. So the first thing I'm gonna do to make sure that it's stable is I'm gonna add foam adhesive to the back of this. I wanna make sure that I add some dimension that way. So again, I took it off camera, and then I'm gonna continue working. Once I added all the die cutouts or all the foam behind it, my next step is to bring color. So you're gonna see that the leftover piece of cardstock that I have, I'm actually gonna bring a pencil and pretty much lay the die cut, the negative piece in this case, on my background. I'm gonna lay it on top of the white cardstock, and lightly with a pencil, I'm just gonna mark where all the little soda tops are located. And that's just gonna give me a good placement or a good idea where I can add the color. Now what I'm using to add the color is the Broken Chevron stencil. I'm gonna use the ink blending tool, and I'm gonna use inks in pink, blue, teal, and purple. So I'm gonna use a rose petal, shades of purple, lapis lazuli, and Sweet Dreams mini cube sets. So all I'm doing is I'm bringing my ink blending tool. You're gonna see that I make sure to mark with some washi tape. I just wanna make sure that I only deposit the color in the area that is behind each one of the little soda top holes, in this case, or negative pieces. So I make sure to add some masking tape and mask the area. And I also, once I put my chevron stencil, I'm also gonna put a little bit of masking tape to hold it in place. This stencil is very delicate, so you're gonna make sure that it doesn't move as much. And all I do then is just bring my ink blending tool, pick up or collect some of the ink. I'm just gonna go on top of my little ink cube, and then I'm gonna go on a circular motion on top of this stencil, and that's just gonna deposit the ink. Like I said before, this stencil is very delicate, the lines are very thin, so I'll suggest that you hold it tight so that the lines don't move much. And that's where you're gonna see that I add quite a bit of washi tape to hold it in place, and I hold the rest with my hand just to add pressure and prevent the lines from moving around too much. And then again, if you have a chance to check the ink blending tool, I suggest you do. It's such a great tool to have, especially if you're creating those inked backgrounds and blending and just working with stencils. This is an amazing tool to have, and it's so easy to work with it. Like I said, all you're gonna need is light pressure on a circular motion on top of a stencil, and you're gonna create the impression. And you're gonna see that I'm gonna go very light with the impression. I just wanna have the shading of the color on the background. And And just to make sure that I'm going in the right weight, I'm going to bring the die cutting piece every so often just to make sure that I have completed all the colors. And then I'm going to take it off camera because I don't want to show you everything. And I went back and just completed all the little spaces. All I'm doing right now is just adding or gluing together the two pieces, the soda top die cut piece to the one that I added color. So you're gonna see that that's where the foam adhesive comes in really handy. It creates the soft shadow, kind of like I said, think of a window between the die cut piece and the inked background. So once I have them together, I'm just gonna trim them and I'm gonna have my background ready. Now here's where the time consuming part took place. And for this, I am actually gonna die cut flowers of the same colors that I have on the background. So you're gonna see that I'm bringing the Beauty Bloom 3D die set, and this is one of the new die sets that was released a couple weeks ago. I'm also gonna bring the Layer Floral Elements die. This is probably the first die set that I got from Altenew. I'm gonna use the grading cardstock in Seashore, in Forest Greens. I'm gonna use Shades of Purple and also Cherry Blossom, and then I'm gonna use some of the paper packs. I'm gonna use the Alluring Blooms, the Fuchsia Soiree, the Summer Blooms. I'm gonna use some papers from the Reflection Kit and also from the Livio Dream. And all I'm gonna do is, these are very simple stencils to layer. They're really tiny, and that makes it so delicate. And it's only three pieces. You're gonna see that you're gonna get the medium shade to go on your base. I'm gonna use the lightest shade of the cardstock to create the detail of the outside of the flower, and then to just give it the detail of the inside of the flower, that's what we're gonna use your darker shade of cardstock or paper. So I'm creating one just to show you using the Shades of Purple paper pack, the gradient cardstock, super easy. But I just don't want to have that just a straight color. I want to have something that's going to bring more interest. And I'm a fan of watercoloring, and the Fuchsia Soiree paper pack has a lot of designs that have a watercolor feeling to it. So instead of me going through creating my own paper, I actually went and pulled papers that are just going to create and give me a variation of colors in the shades of purples, in the shades of blues, pinks, and teals that I'm using. So you're gonna see that I cut, for example, for this flower, I cut a piece, the center comes from the Fuchsia Soiree paper, the outside of the flower comes from the Live Your Dream collection paper, and so does the center. And I pretty much followed the same idea for the entire flowers, and that's where having paper packs, having paper scraps worked really well, because I'm a hoarder, so I tend to save a lot of paper, especially scraps that I know I can use to die cut, and came in really handy right now. Now, out of the Floral Elements die set, I'm just gonna use the little flowers. I don't want to add anything layer. I want the Beauty Blooms to be the ones that actually stand out. So all I'm doing is cutting these little, it looks like little stars. So I'm just going to cut the three different sizes. It comes in medium, large, and small. I'm gonna cut them just to, like I said, help me fill the space. So again, took it off camera, it took quite a bit of time to work together, but it was very relaxing. I just put on some music and just started cutting and gluing. And before I knew it, I had plenty of flowers to create what I have in mind. Now for the background of this layout, I'm actually gonna use a grade cardstock. I didn't want anything white because I want everything to stand out, especially the white die cut piece and the flowers. So I thought that something a little bit darker was gonna make everything stand out. And I wanted something also that had a cool feeling, because the picture that I'm documenting is, this is a selfie of my family, the last selfie of 2018. So again, I had two pictures. I sized them small so that they fit in the inside, not inside, but around the same size as one of the Sora top nesting dies. So you're gonna see that I'm just backing my picture with a paper from the Summer Gardens paper pack, and it just has all those shades that I'm working with. And I don't wanna completely frame it, I just wanna bring some of the color, especially to the outside picture, the one that's gonna be outside of the strip of paper. So again, a little bit of foam adhesive behind it just so that it sits flush or a little bit higher than the background that I created. And here is, you're gonna see foam adhesive is my best friend, I think. And here's when I'm gonna start working with all the flowers that I die cut. And my idea is I literally wanna filled some of the spaces that I created with the Sora top nesting dies, but I don't wanna fill the entire space. Think of it, I'm gonna create a zigzag throughout the entire strip of paper using the little empty spots. So I'm gonna make sure that some of the flowers look like they're coming from behind or from underneath the die cut, and some of them are gonna be higher. You're gonna see that I'm gonna start by working with the beady bloomed flowers, just cause they have, like I said, I created ones that from the gradient cardstock, so they look flat. Like what I mean by flat is one single color. And I also cut some of the flowers from all the paper packs, so they have more of a watercolor look. So I want to make sure that I mix those just so that I have all the shades of purple in one, in this case what I'm creating in that pocket, in that area. And then I'm going to bring those tiny little flowers, just think of it as filler flowers, to kind of bulk up the cluster. And then I use the dies, I use the leaf and the branches from the beady blooms and also the layer floral elements die just to create those branches and the leaves. And I'm just gonna use those to help me create create that curvature of the sort of top a space or pocket, whichever way you want to call it. I'm going to call it a window. And I'm going to make sure that I color block. And what I mean by color block is I'm going to use purple on the purple space and blue on the blue space and so on. Now for my title, I knew already that I wanted to use just die cuts to create this layout. So I went and pulled the handwritten hello die set, and I'm actually going to cut it out of the leftover white paper that I had when I created my background. So there's some spaces that still have a little bit of ink. I'm gonna use the little bit of ink area to cut the word us, and I'm using the bold alphabet die for that. So I'm gonna make sure that the U and the S have a little bit of that inking detail, and I'm gonna make sure that the hello, I'm gonna cut both of them, the really thin handwritten look and die, and also the one that has that offset. I'm gonna cut them both out of the white part of the leftover cardstock because I want to make sure that that's completely white, just to bring some of that white that I have on the background. Then all I'm gonna do, you're gonna see that I'm gonna layer the hellos together just to give me that 3D look of it, just to give a little bit more of a dimension. I'm gonna glue them together. I cut the word us another time out of the leftover pieces of cardstock that I have, and I'm gonna layer them together just again to add a little bit of dimension. And all I'm gonna do is I'm gonna glue the word us right underneath the left hand side picture, and then I'm gonna use some glue to stick the word hello right on top of the picture. I make sure that I had quite a bit of negative space, so I'm not gonna cover any faces. I'm okay if I cover my hand because I'm holding a camera, so nothing fancy. Once I have that, I'm actually gonna bring all those leftover flowers, not all of them, but I'm actually gonna bring all the colors that I have on the little windows of the die cut, of the background in this case, onto the left, right behind the word hello. Just think that's gonna create that movement. Again, you're gonna see it's kind of a zigzag. It's gonna give me a focal point. It's gonna bring the attention to the title. And all I'm doing is just bringing all the colors together on the left-hand side of the page. Once I have all of that, I'm gonna add a few lines of journal right underneath the word us. And then I went onto my stash and I found a few phrase stickers markers that actually match the colors of the background. So you're gonna see this one that says Tamwood family, and then I'm gonna bring some stickers that have a little bit of fuchsia just to pick up the colors in the cherry blossoms paper pack. I'm gonna bring ones that had this really soft pink, and I'm gonna bring some blue and a little bit of teal, and I'm just gonna place them in that empty space that I have above the flowers inside the soda top pocket in this case. And that's just gonna emphasize the color. It's not gonna cover the complete area, but it's gonna bring a little bit extra, a little bit of sentiment. And because I already have all those flowers, I don't need that much more embellishment. All you're gonna see me bring is a few little I think I'm using resin hearts. Again, I had them in my stash. I wanted something a little bit bigger than the Altenew enamel dots. So these ones were a little bit bigger. And just to finish this, I'm gonna bring a little bit extra white onto the layout. So I'm using the Pure White ink. This is the spray from Altenew. And I'm just gonna add a few splatters to each one of the corners of the floral clusters. That's about it. I love how this turned out. It took me, I'm not gonna lie, it took me an entire morning just because I had to die cut everything, but I love how this turned out. Probably one of my favorite layouts that I've done this year so far. I just love the color combination. I love all the little flowers. I love how delicate they are. They're intrinsic. They're very, like, even though they're delicate and small, they're very detailed, and I love that, and I love the color. And as always, guys, if you have any questions on how this came together, do not hesitate to contact me. Don't forget to check the blog to see more details. And thank you so much for joining me. Bye-bye, guys.
Hello, crafters. I hope you enjoyed that video. If you want to see more, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the notification bell so you don't miss anything. Thanks for watching.